Hello guys, welcome back to a brand new video and welcome today to a very special WWE 2K simulation. Because in this video here today, we are going to be seeing what happens when AEW All Elite Wrestling invades WWE NXT and when the Wednesday Night Wars become an actual reality. Because it's one thing to sit here on Twitter seeing people argue about numbers regarding a TV show. I don't really understand it either, but it is one thing to watch those people argue on Twitter every single week. It's another to see the actual superstars go at it. And today, we're going to see what happens when that happens. I didn't even know if that made any sense, but hopefully you understand what I was saying. Anyway, AEW invading NXT, something that a lot of people have thought about happening, and I think if it did happen one day, it would be insane, but the likelihood of it happening is, kind of like the likelihood of Chad Gable ever becoming a world champion, which really pains me to say for Shorty G. But I guess what I'm trying to say is that AEW invading NXT or vice versa, NXT invading AEW is probably never going to happen, but I think it would be really cool if it did happen one day, and so why not go ahead in universe mode and see how it would turn out when superstars like the Young Bucks go ahead and go up against the Undisputed Era, or Adam Cole against Kenny Omega, something that we've seen in the past before, but we've never seen it in NXT. I mean, what about a Cody Rhodes against a Finn Balor for the TNT Championship, a Darby Allin versus Dexter Lumis? All these kind of rivalries that could happen, and so without any more further ado, let's jump into WWE 2K Universe mode again to see what happens when AEW invades NXT. So now let's go ahead and run down the AEW / NXT combined roster here. But one thing I will preface this with is the fact that this is coming off the heels of my Triple H AEW simulation video, which you saw a couple days ago. And so a lot of the AEW superstars here are going to be kind of beefed up because, you know, they're higher in the power rankings, or, you know, they've generally just been a lot more active recently. But also, NXT has still been going on the side, so I imagine they will be beefed up as well and ready for war. Because, you know, in real life, if AEW did end up invading NXT, they'd be ready for war. They'd be getting beefed up and everything, and they need to be. AEW really needs to be beefed up and ready for war when it comes to going to NXT, because I mean, that NXT parking lot is top 5 most dangerous places in the world. I mean, seriously, have you seen how much has happened in that NXT parking lot over the years? People are getting attacked, people are getting kidnapped, people are getting mugged. It's absolutely insane what happens in that parking lot, and I swear to God, it would genuinely be a great YouTube video to see someone try and survive 24 hours in the NXT parking lot before something happens, because I'm convinced they would not make it out alive. Especially not with that creepy bastard Dexter Lumis running around. But anyway, let's run through this AEW / NXT combined roster now. First things first, we've got AEW Women's Champion Abaddon, now heading over to NXT. Adam Cole, Bebe, Awesome Kong, Bobby Fish, half of the NXT Tag Team Champions. We've got Brandi Rhodes, we've got Brian Cage, Britt Baker DMD, Bronson Reed, Cameron Grimes, Candice LeRae, Cash Wheeler, who, by the way, the Revival are coming back, but they're under their AEW names because, you know, it's like two different universes, but I don't know. Cash Wheeler, there you go. he's in NXT, he's back. Chelsea Green, Chris Jericho, Christopher Daniels, Chuck Taylor, Cody Rhodes, who is the AEW World Champion, by the way, right now. Dakota Kai, Damian Priest, Darby Allin, Dax Howard, of course, making his return to NXT, Dexter Lumis, that creepy murderous bastard, Dominik Dijakovic, Dustin Rhodes, Ember Moon, Evil Uno, Finn Balor, Hangman Adam Page, Hanson, Hikaru Shida, Ilya Dragunov, Io Shirai, Isaiah Swerve Scott, Jake Hager, Jimmy Havoc, Joey Janela, Johnny Gargano, Jon Moxley, Jungle Boy. Everybody take a deep breath, here we go for the second half. Karrion Kross, Kazarian, Keith Lee was the NXT champion, Kenny Omega, Kushida. Oh yeah, Kenny Omega's coming back, by the way. He was in NXT like a week ago in these simulations. He is coming back. Kenny Omega, the best belt machine, is back. But anyway, Kyle O'Reilly, half of the NXT Tag Team Champions, Lance Archer, Luchasaurus, Matt Cardona, Matt Hardy, Matt Jackson, Matt Riddle, Matt Sydal, Maxwell Jacob Friedman, Miro, Nick Jackson, Nyla Rose, Orange Cassidy, Ortiz, Pac, who is the TNT champion, by the way, Pentagon Jr., Pete Dunne, Rhea Ripley is the NXT Women's Champion, Ricky Starks, Roderick Strong, Rowe, Sammy Guevara. Jesus Christ, there are so many for this roster rundown now. It's increasingly going to my head. Santana, Scorpio Sky, Sean Spears, Shotzi Blackheart, Sunny Kiss, Tay Conti, who, by the way, is coming over from AEW. She was in NXT like a year ago, but she's back anyway. Tegan Nox, Thunder Rosa, Tommaso Ciampa, Tony Storm, Trent Beretta, Trent Seven, Tyler Bate, Walter, the UK champion, Wardlow, Will Hobbs, who... I know what you're thinking. Why is his render D'Lo Brown? I couldn't find a render for Will Hobbs anywhere on the internet, so I was just like, you know what? D'Lo Brown. Because why the hell not, really? I don't know. I make the rules. Anyway, Xia Li is also a new addition to the NXT roster, and there we go. There is your NXT AEW hybrid roster here for today. But anyway, going back here, we've got an AEW match on NXT this week, okay? I mean, I was kind of hoping in this simulation that we, you know, where AEW is invading NXT, we'd be fighting NXT guys, but sure, this makes sense. Anyway, MJF against Matt Hardy. Matt Hardy picks up the win here on NXT. Ember Moon beats Rhea Ripley, the champion. Dominik Dijakovic beats Roderick Strong. Cody beat... Okay, let me take back what I was just saying. Okay, Cody interrupting the NXT champion. Is this where we're going already? All right, Universe Mode, I see you, big man. The AEW World Champion is facing the NXT champion. We're just jumping straight into this, okay? The simulation is off to a hot start. Cody beats Keith Lee in a promo, and Walter beats Finn Balor in a promo at the end. And MJF is on the cover of this week on NXT, but the Undisputed Era's Roderick Strong loses to Dominik Dijakovic. Brian Cage with Taz in his corner. Team Taz has beaten Keith Lee, the NXT champion. Thunder Rosa has beaten Rhea Ripley. I'm enjoying this so far. This is a bunch of dream matches happening. Matt Sydal has beaten Walter. My God, wow. And in the main event, Damian Priest has beaten Maxwell Jacob Freeman. Okay, so let's look. AEW won there. Didn't win the main event. Thunder Rosa. Generally, AEW is doing really good so far. Okay. AEW faithful watching this video are like, yeah, fuck NXT. Yeah. We beat you guys in the ratings a couple weeks ago or whenever. I don't know. I don't really pay attention to that. I'm not going to lie. I find it a little bit depressing that grown men argue on Twitter over ratings of a TV show they have no part in, I'm just gonna be honest. But for me at least, and for the people looking on from the outside, it is a very fun conversation to observe you guys arguing about a bunch of numbers, so keep it up. But anyway, another episode of NXT here where Maxwell Jacob Freeman has lost to Pentagon Jr. Karrion Kross has beaten Keith Lee. Sean Spears is back in NXT. Of course, Ty Dillinger, formerly known as, beats Roderick Strong. Thunder Rosa wins a triple threat with Abaddon in there as well. And Walter beats Finn Balor. June week one here on NXT where Isaiah Swerve Scott has lost to Cody in a triple threat match. The NXT champion is down bad ever since AEW arrived, okay? Jimmy Havoc has beaten Maxwell Jacob Freeman. Hangman Adam Page has beaten Roderick Strong. Finn Balor beats Walter. And Rhea Ripley beats Abaddon in the main event. And by the way, I forgot to say at the beginning of this, but AEW Dynamite is still going on, by the way. Like, they're invading NXT, but they're not a part of the NXT roster. They're just coming in here and doing their damn thing, you know, in a classic invasion style. But there is still a chance that AEW Dynamite could be having title matches for the world title, and the title could be changing hands. I guess I won't know. I mean, I guess we can go next week in the simulation and check out AEW Dynamite just to see what's going on over there. But MJF and Wardlow have split up, and MJF wins that war. Pentagon Jr. has pinned Roderick Strong. Keith Lee has won a triple threat match with Brian Cage in there. Ortiz and Santana have beaten FTR on NXT. And the Young Bucks have been the team of Walter and Finn Balor in the main event. But you know what, real quick, let's go ahead and see what's happening on Dynamite right here. Okay, no title match is interesting. Also worth noting, by the way, that Jon Moxley has yet to be seen on NXT TV, okay? Maybe Tony Khan is saving the big man for a later point in the invasion right here. He's just letting the guys do their thing. You know, these guys right here, Luchasaurus and Jungle Boy picking up a win over FTR. He's letting them slowly seep into the system, and then he will release Jon Moxley. And even Kenny Omega we haven't seen yet, but Roderick Strong beat Sean Spears. Colin O'Reilly beat British Strong Style. Finn Balor beats Walter, and okay, what was I just saying? You know what? Never mind. I was literally just saying Jon Moxley is going to come in when Tony Khan needs him, and here he is. Interestingly enough, to lose to Maxwell Jacob Friedman, though, so. Anyway, moving on to the final week of June here, where Ciampa has beaten Roderick Strong in a promo. British Strong Style have lost to the UE again. The Young Bucks have lost to Lucha Express. Walter has beaten Finn Balor, and MJF has beaten Miro in the main event. Miro back in NXT, hashtag Rusev Day. And now we're heading into July week one here, where the first takeover, Takeover Chicago is coming up, so that should be interesting. MJF beats Pentagon Jr. Matt Hardy has beaten Roderick Strong. Colin O'Reilly have once again beaten British Strong Style. You hate to see it. Dax Harwood has beaten Luchasaurus. And Walter has beaten the big man Bronson Reed. All right. And with Trent Beretta on the cover of TakeOver. Oh, this is a kind of a dream match for me, low key. Here at TakeOver Chicago, Io Shirai against Abaddon. She beats Abaddon. Okay. And the first AEW title change. Well, not the first AEW title change, but you know what I'm saying. The first AEW guys to pick up titles, Scorpio Sky and Kazarian of SCU, have beaten the Undisputed Era for the NXT tag titles. That's one, fellas. That is one. The AEW roster officially have one championship to their boards right here. But anyway, did any other titles change hands? FTR beat Lucha Express. Dom Dijak has won a North American title from Roderick Strong. Finn Balor has not won the United Kingdom Championship. Keith Lee has retained the NXT Championship against Cody Rhodes. And Santana and Ortiz have beaten Beretta and Taylor in the main event. Ladder match. But now we move on to July week two, where MJF has just decided to glow in the opening. Yeah, that's pretty MJF right there, to be fair. Isaiah Scott beats Karrion Kross. Lucha Express beat Proud and Powerful. Dominik Dijakovic beats Tommaso Ciampa, and Finn Balor and Walter do their thing. And Luchasaurus was on the cover of this week of NXT, where Pentagon Jr. has beaten MJF. Johnny Gargano is back and he's beaten Finn Balor. Okay, former NXT alumni, or former AEW alumni, Johnny Gargano, except, you know, he was murdered in that universe simulation, so, you know. But anyway, moving on, Darby Allin is here on NXT to beat Isaiah Scott. Okay, Orange Cassidy has lost to Dom Dijak with the Best Friends in his corner, and Lucha Express win the main event. July week 4 here on NXT, where Finn Balor has lost to Walter, Isaiah Scott has beaten the new NXT champion, British Strong Style beaten Pentagon Jr. and MJF, we love to see that, Dax Harwood and Cash Wheeler have beaten Luchasaurus and Jungle Boy, and Tommaso Ciampa has beaten the NXT North American champion in the main event. August week 1, where Finn Balor is on the cover, Maxwell Jacob Friedman has lost to Pentagon, Santana and Ortiz have beaten Beretta and Taylor, Ricky Starks and Matt Cardona are teaming up, okay. Are we about to see Matt Cardona join Team Taz? Because I don't want to see that. But anyway, we've got Luchasaurus has beaten Dax Harwood and Darby Allin beats Finn Balor in the main event. But now we are here, the go home show to NXT TakeOver Brooklyn, where Lucha Express have beaten FTR once again. Rowan Hansen have beaten Sunny Kiss and Evil Uno. Wait, Sunny Kiss, are you joining the Dark Order? Okay, you know what, you do you. Anyway, Dominik Dijakovic has beaten Kenny Omega, who is on the card facing the North American champion. Okay, we'll keep an eye on that situation. Finn Balor and Walter do their thing, and Pentagon beats MJF again. And by all indicators, Keith Lee is main eventing this takeover right here, where, wow, the NXT tag titles are on the line between two AEW teams. Wow, fuck NXT, huh? Jesus Christ, they got out of that tag picture quick. Okay, Santana and Ortiz have won the NXT tag titles. Okay, that was fast and efficient. Rhea Ripley retains the NXT Women's Championship, though. FTR have been Lucha Express at TakeOver. Finn Balor cannot win the UK title again. And Matt Jackson is beating Bobby Fish of the UE. Okay, wait a second, that was a six-man normal tag, but it just hasn't loaded in anyone else. Okay. Well, despite what you can see on your screen right here, it says six-man normal tag, so I'm assuming that was supposed to be the Young Bucks or maybe the full elite of Kenny Omega, Matt Jackson, and Nick Jackson against the UE, which kind of is fire. I mean, not even kind of, that is a fire matchup right there. So I guess the elite have beaten the Undisputed Era at TakeOver. I'm going to assume that is. 1 point for the AEW card again, or an extra point. I don't know what I'm talking about. You know what I'm trying to say. Anyway, moving on. British Strong Style beating MJF and Pentagon, you love to see that. And in the main event, Cody does not win the NXT tag title or the NXT championship again. Now we move on to August week 3 here, where Hangman Adam Page and Dustin Rhodes have changed to FTR. Okay, anyway, moving on. Ilya Dragunov wins a triple threat match. Chris Jericho is on NXT to beat MJF. Okay, nice one seeing you, Chris Jericho, in game, not so much in real life with your stupid idiotness. Anyway, Walter has beaten Finn Balor, and Dom Dijak and Tommaso Ciampa do their thing in the main event. You know what I want to go ahead and check real quick? Let me just go ahead and see. Okay, the champions are pretty much all the same, besides the fact that SCU have won the AEW World Tag Team Championships. They're kind of on a roll right now. Over there on AEW, I mean, all the champions have remained the same as far as I can remember. Abaddon was still, yeah, she was still the women's champion, so she couldn't win the title from Rhea Ripley. That was champion versus champion. But as far as SCU goes, they were the NXT Tag Champions, and now they are the AEW World Tag Team Champions. Okay. Okay, I see you. But anyway, final week of August here on NXT. Matt Riddle has beaten Dom Dijak. Rowan Hansen have beaten Ricky Starks and Evil Uno. Apparently, Starks is joining. He's going from Team Taz to Dark Order. Okay, interesting. Walter has beaten Finn Balor. Matt Sydal beats Pentagon Jr. And FTR have beaten the Young Bucks in the main event of NXT. But anyway, September week 1 here at NXT, where the Young Bucks have beaten the Lucha Express. Cody Rhodes has won a triple threat match with Isaiah Scott and Karrion Kross. Pentagon Jr. has beaten Johnny Gargano. Tommaso Ciampa beats Dom Dijak. And Finn Balor has beaten Walter. Very interesting right there. I think that was a clean sweep for AEW on that episode of NXT right there. Miro against Walter, and Miro has beaten the United Kingdom champion. We love to see that. Rusev Day. Anyway, moving on, Keith Lee has beaten Isaiah Scott. Undisputed Era have beaten MJF and Pentagon Jr., who seem to be, they've had a lot of tag matches recently, so are these guys becoming friends or something? I don't know. Speaking of becoming friends, Tommaso Ciampa and Dom Dijak, two rivals, have beaten British Strong Style Mustache Mountain. Matt Jackson has beaten Dax Harwood in the main event. Anyway, now moving on for another episode of NXT here, where Matt Jackson has beaten Christopher Daniels. Hanson and Rowe of the War Machine Rowe Raiders what are they called? War Machine, War Raiders, Viking Raiders, whatever they're called, the Vikings have beaten Evil Uno and Ricky Starks. Pentagon Jr. and MJF's tag team is done. Finn Balor has beaten Walter in a promo, and Wardlow has lost to Ciampa in the main event. Now it is time for the final week of the month here on NXT, where Bronson Reed has beaten Pentagon Jr., Proud and Powerful have beaten the Best Friends, Hanson and Rowe have lost to Evil Uno and D'Lo Brown. You already heard my explanation for that situation, but yeah, Will Hobbs and Evil Uno teaming up. But anyway, Tommaso Ciampa is your new North American champion, and Matt Jackson has beaten Dax Harwood. Now it is a new month here in October on NXT, where Pentagon has beaten MJF. This feud has been going on forever, by the way. Proud and Powerful, the NXT Tag Team Champions, are beating the Best Friends. Hanson and Rowe have beaten Matt Cardona and Ricky Starks. Walter has beaten Finn Balor in a promo, and FTR have pinned the Young Bucks. Another week, another edition of NXT, where British Strong Style have lost to MJF and Pentagon Jr., again going for a tag team division or something. Brian Cage and Taz have beaten Isaiah Swerve Scott. Finn Balor has lost to Matt Hardy. Dominik Dijakovic has beaten Matt Sydal. And Dax Howell beats Matt Jackson again. Maximo Jacob Friedman is on the cover of this edition of NXT, where Finn Balor has beaten Walter. Dom Dijak has beaten Jimmy Havoc, who is on NXT today. Okay. Cody is back in the winning column against Isaiah Swerve Scott. The Young Bucks have pinned FTR. And Pentagon Jr. has beaten MJF in the main event. Final week of October, when Matt Sydal has beaten Hangman Adam Page. Karrion Kross has beaten Isaiah Swerve Scott. MJF and Pentagon again. Apparently, this rivalry is destined to fight forever anyway. Finn Balor has beaten Walter, and Matt Jackson beats Christopher Daniels in the main event. You know what, real quick, now that we're at the start of November, let's see who the champions are over there in AEW, okay? They're the exact same as they were 2 months ago, okay? We haven't really seen too much of Pac on NXT. I'd love to see him, you know, jump ship and face some people soon. But Cody is still your AEW World Champion, by the way, so, you know, he didn't beat Keith Lee at Brooklyn, but he's still the champion, so... Anyway, another edition of NXT here, where Shawn Spears has lost to Matt Sydal. Keith Lee has beaten Isaiah Swerve Scott, the NXT champion, doing his thing finally. MJF has beaten Damian Priest. Finn Balor is your new NXT UK champion, and the Young Bucks have beaten FTR. November week 2 here on NXT, where Matt Sydal has beaten Hangman Adam Page. Dakota Kai has beaten Rhea Ripley. That's pretty big for her, by the way, pinning the champion. The Viking War Machine Raiders have beaten Matt Cardona and Will Hobbs. Dax Howard pins Matt Jackson, one half of the Young Bucks, and MJF has beaten Pentagon Jr. Oh god, look who it is. This creepy murderous bastard Dexter Lumis has beaten. He's killed Matt Sydal. You just know, RIP Matt Sydal, we won't forget you. The best friends have beaten the NXT Tag Team Champions, okay? MJF once again has beaten Pentagon Jr. because apparently this simulation is all about them. I mean, holy shit, can I see some new matches? Okay, there's a new match. Hikaru Shida has shown up to NXT to beat Tony Storm. You love to see that. And in the main event, FTR have beaten the Young Bucks again. But anyway, it's now time for the final week of November here, where Abaddon has beaten Tony Storm. Okay, that's a big dub. The NXT Tag Team Champions have beaten Lucha Express. FTR have beaten Trent Beretta and Chuck Taylor, the best friends. Hikaru Shida has beaten Dakota Kai. She is undefeated since coming to AEW. And Matt Sydal has beaten Pentagon Jr. in the main event. But anyway, you know the drill. Another episode of NXT here, where Kenny Omega has appeared here on NXT to take out MJF and beat Pentagon Jr. Okay, Kenny, I see you, big man. I see you, best bat machine. But anyway, Brian Cage has pinned the NXT champion. That's pretty big. Tegan Nox beats her former tag team partner of Team Kick, Dakota Kai. Britt Baker DMD is here now. Okay, the women's division is slowly creeping up here. It's slowly coming up, but Britt Baker has beaten Tony Storm, and Matt Sydal beats Will Hobbs in the main event. Well, now moving on for another NXT here, where of course MJF and Pentagon, I'm about to just stop reading out their names because I'm sick and tired of this match being over and over and over again. Ortiz and Santana beat the best friends. Keith Lee beats Isaiah Swerve Scott, and Awesome Kong is on this episode of NXT where she beats Tony Storm. Tony Storm is doing the job for every AEW woman in existence. And of course in the main event, Matt beats the other Matt. But now it is time for December week 3 here on NXT, where Tony Storm finally gets a win back over Chelsea Green. MJF has been dusted Dustin Rhodes, nice to see a different matchup right there. Dakota Kai has beaten Brandi Rhodes, the CEO or whatever she is, I don't know. CBO, I think she is actually. Same as Stephanie McMahon. Anyway, Darby Allin has beaten the NXT champion Keith Lee. Okay, we'll love to see that. Matt Sydal beats Lance Archer in the main event. Anyway, it is now time for the final NXT of the year here in December week 4, where Tony Storm beats Britt Baker in a promo. Kazarian and Scorpio Sky beat the best friends. Brian Cage has once again pinned the NXT champion. Is that a sign of things to come? We'll see. MJF and Pentagon, I don't care. Whatever. The Proud and Powerful have beaten Jimmy Havoc and Will Hobbs. But now here in NXT, it is a new year. Yes, it is, because Santana and Ortiz have once again beaten the best friends. Okay, the more things change, the more they stay the same. But anyway, Rhea Ripley beats Dakota Kai and Candice LeRae in a triple threat match. Brian Cage has been the NXT champion again. MJF has beaten Kushida, interesting. And Britt Baker beats Tony Storm in the main event promo. I mean, I'm not gonna lie, it's kind of hard for me to imagine Britt Baker ever losing a promo, considering she just has that one thing that she can whip out and she never loses a promo. Tony Storm, with your stupid glasses and your punk rock attitude, did you know that I'm a dentist? And now moving on here to January week 2, where Tony Storm has lost to Dakota Kai. Ricky Starks has beaten Will Hobbs, okay. British Strong Style are back in the winning column against the UE. Cody has once again beaten Keith Lee in a call-out promo. Is this guy going for the NXT Championship again? It was already bad enough that you were the Triple H of AEW. Now you come over here and you were the Triple H of NXT. I don't know what you're thinking. Triple H is NXT. No, Cody Rhodes is Triple H, in where Triple H is in... Yeah. Oh my god, I'm so sick and tired of seeing this match. MJF beats Pentagon again. End this goddamn rivalry already. Is this still going? Seriously, my god. Oh, thank god it's got 1 week remaining and then it is done, hopefully forever, because I'm sick and tired of this right now. It's been going since July week 2. That is like a 5 month feud right there. Oh my god, look who's on the cover. It's MJF. I already don't like this guy's personality enough. He's already a son of a bitch and now he's just being annoying, straight up. But Yes, I really almost did just say Brick Baker DMD versus Tegan Nox. But anyway, moving on, Ricky Starks has beaten Evil Uno. Xia Li is finally on NXT to beat Dakota Kai. Darby Allin has beaten Keith Lee in a promo. Okay, the NXT champion down bad. Maxwell Jacob Friedman, I did just say 1 week remaining, so surely this has got to be the end, or else I'm deleting the feud. I'm not supposed to step in or play God, but I will be for this situation because I am sick of this. Anyway, we have now arrived at the penultimate takeover here, where Lance Archer has not won the North American Championship, but he's in the title picture. Finn Balor retains against Dustin Rhodes, the UK title. Abaddon is a multi-time champion right now, I think. Hang on a second, let me go ahead and check this before whatever happens. Let me see this. Edit championships. Yeah, Abaddon is now the AEW Women's Champion and the NXT Women's Champion. All right, Abaddon, I see you. The zombies are running wild out here, but anyway, let's go ahead and go back to TakeOver. So yeah, Abaddon dethrones Rhea Ripley. Britt Baker DMD has beaten Tony Storm. AEW is running this card so far. Pentagon Jr. beats Damian Priest. Cash Wheeler and Dax Howard have beaten Cameron Grimes and Sonny Kiss. Is this a clean sweep for AEW in the main event? Hang on, are we about to see? Oh my goodness. Oh my god. I mean, was I really lying when I said Cody was the Triple H of NXT and AEW? Because this guy came and he was already world champion. He was just like, you know what? I'm going to keep booking myself until I win the title. And now here we are. Cody is the champion. A double champion, by the way. So, sorry, Keith Lee, but you are no longer the champion. Now we've got two double champions from the AEW roster. And I think Santana and Ortiz are still the NXT tag champions as well. So if someone takes that North American title, AEW is going to have a clean sweep across the board. Across the board in this simulation. And I'm not gonna lie, I love NXT, but I'm kind of pulling for them right here. I want them to win all the belts. But anyway, Keith Lee has beaten Darby Allin. Okay, that doesn't really matter right now. You're not the champion anymore. Evil Uno beats Will Hobbs, D'Lo Brown. Ricky Starks loses to Matt Cardona. Jimmy Havoc beats MJF. And Britt Baker, DMD, and Tony Storm do their thing. Another episode of NXT here where Abaddon, the NXT Women's Champion, and AEW Women's Champion has lost to Dakota Kai. Okay, that's pretty big. Ricky Starks beats Evil Uno and... Why is it still here? Why? Why? No, 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 no. I'm not doing this. I'm not doing this anymore. We're done. We are done. Are you fucking kidding me? From July week 2 until where are we right now? We are in February week 1. 6 month feud. For what? Why? Between those two? Really? Anyway, moving on, Britt Baker has beaten Tony Storm and Darby Allin has pinned the former NXT champion. Okay, I'm so sorry to step in and play God, but I'm sick and tired of seeing these two people. I swear to God, if I see MJF and Pentagon Jr. again on this card after deleting that rivalry, they are both getting released from AEW and NXT because I'm sick and fucking tired. But anyway, Io Shirai loses to Britt Baker DMD. That's pretty big. Ricky Starks beats Will Hobbs. Adam Cole and Kyle O'Reilly beat British Strong Style. Hikaru Shida wins a triple threat match. And Darby Allin beats Keith Lee. No MJF or Pentagon Jr. Yes. February week 3 here on NXT, where Britt Baker has once again beaten Tony Storm. Matt Cardona has beaten Evil Uno. Ricky Starks beats Will Hobbs. Sean Spears beats the former North American champion, Dominik Dijakovic. And Darby Allin has beaten the former NXT champion. Listen, I know I've already said it multiple times in this video, but Cody Rhodes, the Triple H of NXT, has done something that Triple H has done before. He's won the title and he's taken it somewhere. No, nowhere to defend or even be on TV. He's just taking it. The comparisons are uncanny in my opinion, but anyway. It is now time for the final week of February here, where British Strong Style once again have lost. We just know the drill by now. It's depressing to see. Ricky Starks has beaten Evil Uno. Sean Spears beats Dustin Rhodes. Darby Allin and Keith Lee team up to beat Lucha Express. And Britt Baker DMD has beaten Tony Storm. I'm not gonna lie, by the way, Britt Baker has low-key been on a roll. I'm kind of noticing that in the background a little bit. But anyway, Sean Spears has beaten Matt Hardy. Evil Uno beats Sonny Kiss. Ricky Starks has beaten Matt Cardona. Britt Baker once again has beaten Tony Storm. Darby Allin has beaten Keith Lee. But now moving on for another NXT here in March week 2, I think, where Sean Spears beats Bronson Reed, Ricky Starks beats Matt Cardona, Abaddon has beaten the former champion Rhea Ripley, Adam Cole has beaten Hangman Adam Page, okay. Two men with extensive history when it comes to being the elite, but anyway, and Tommaso Ciampa, the North American champion, has pinned the NXT and AEW champion. There's a lot of championships in this match right here. Another week on NXT where Adam Cole has lost to Johnny Gargano, Dakota Kai has beaten Thunder Rosa, Nyla Rose has beaten Awesome Kong, Sean Spears has beaten Damian Priest, and Cody has beaten Tommaso Ciampa in a call-out promo. Oh my god. I can already tell what happened here. Cody lost to Tommaso Ciampa once and now he's calling him out. You just know he's embodying Triple H right here. Ugh, you will not beat me. I'll beat you, you son of a bitch. I mean, I know I said it already, but the comparisons are just uncanny. Cody is going to do a Triple H right now. Tommaso Ciampa, I am so sorry for what is about to happen to you. Hey, yo, wait a second. I just realized, oh my god, Cody may end this simulation with AEW's title, NXT's world title, and the North America. Surely there's no way. Say it ain't so. Oh my god, we're getting down into the nitty gritty now. This might actually happen. Okay, Tommaso Ciampa has beaten Kushida. Brandi Rhodes beats Awesome Kong. Pac is on NXT. He beats Matt Hardy. Sean Spears beats Johnny Gargano. And Abaddon, the NXT Women's Champion, beats Thunder Rosa. And now here we are on the go home show to the final NXT takeover of the simulation where Cody is on the cover, by the way. Roderick Strong beats Sean Spears. Awesome Kong has beaten Rhea Ripley. Pac and Bronson Reed do their thing. Abaddon beats Chelsea Green. And Kenny Omega has pinned the champion in the main event. But now everyone take a deep breath, because we're here at the final stop of this year's simulation at NXT TakeOver New Orleans, where Dominik Dijakovic and Karrion Kross, what a weird tag team that is, but they pick up the title, so it worked. Good for them. They beat AEW, one point to NXT on this card. Trent Barretta and Chuck Taylor beat Lucha Express. I'm counting that as an AEW win, regardless. Another AEW win right there. Anyway, Finn Balor beats Walter for the UK Championship. Adam Cole has beaten Pac. Okay, I swear Pac was a TNT champion, though. I guess he just didn't put it on the line. Anyway, Thunder Rosa does not win the NXT Women's Championship. And in the main event, what am I about to see here in the final match of this simulation with Cody Rhodes? Of course. What a place to wrap this up. Hang on a second, I need to see this right now with my own eyes. Okay, AEW World Champion. On NXT, let's go ahead over here and see NXT Champion and the North American Champion. And that, ladies and gentlemen, is about where I'm going to wrap up this simulation, because that's pretty much, that sums up everything I need to say, really. I don't need to say anything else. But I mean, in conclusion, I would say that AEW definitely won the war against NXT here on Wednesday nights, especially in this simulation where Cody won everything, Abaddon won everything, and in the tag team division, they dominated as well. So, yeah, AEW for life, baby. Oh, I don't know what the hell I'm talking about, but if you enjoyed this simulation, then please drop a like on it. It will just help Allison YouTube a lot more than you think. And also subscribe and turn up post notifications so you don't miss any up and coming content on the channel. And also we're on the road to 20k. So thank you so much for watching. Hope you guys have a great day. And that's been it. Too sweet.